A massive new scam underway tonight across the country, taking advantage of a lot of Americans. It begins with a member of your family answering the phone. The con man operating overseas poses the police, hounding and tricking people into sending them money. ABC's chief investigative correspondent Brian Ross set out on the trail.
To get American consumers to pay debts they don't really owe, the scammers often pose as police officers, threatening to make arrests.
My name is Officer William Johnson.
And they somehow have the victim's social security numbers.
Let me reveal the last 4 digits of your social. It's 9281.
The calls to Cindy Gervais of New Orleans started long after she and her husband had taken out and paid off an online loan. But she was told falsely she still owed more.
And that I was no good deadbeat. I would have the worst. I would spend the night in jail and my family would be able to get me out.
So she sent them more than $1,800 to pay off a debt she did not owe. Authorities say the scammers buy their victims' names and financial information from dishonest online payday loan brokers.
That information is on the internet and it's accessible to these scam artists.
Federal authorities say the calls can be traced to a major organized crime group in India, where call centers have targeted hundreds of thousands of Americans. ABC News went to one of the companies alleged to be involved, where employees denied any knowledge of the scam, but refused to let us inside.
Can you please switch off this first of all?
Federal authorities say the scam would not be possible without the help of American frontmen, including Kirit Patel of Tracy, California. Patel is accused by the Federal Trade Commission of setting up the American companies where victims were told to send their payments. Patel claims he knows nothing about the phone scam run out of India.
I have no comments, sir.
What do you mean you have no? Do you have an apology?
I have no comments. I have written an attorney.
Where's the money? Can you tell us that?
I have no comments.
The Federal Trade Commission has now frozen Patel's bank account, but most of the money, millions of dollars, has already gone to India, where there is little the U.S. can do to get it back or to stop the scam from continuing, Diane.
Big heads up tonight. Thank you, Brian. I know you'll have more of your reporting tonight on Nightline. Be sure to watch.